So one of the more important outcomes of training should be posture. We should constantly be working and striving towards better posture, not only for performance, it's going to save our spine in the long run, and frankly, we're going to look better, confident, stronger. It's going to help you age better. It just is one of the considerations we should always be working on. And yet, so much of our training seems to jeopardize posture. We constantly make choices that are either just poor movement choices, or we do good movements badly. So today we're going to talk about the sled tug. It's sort of a staple in the nouveau physical culture world right now, and that's a good thing. It has a lot of skill crossover. It's great for performance enhancing. It's going to make you strong. It's going to build your heart and lungs and all blah, 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 blah. But only if you do it better. So let's work on it. Here's the thing. Our big performance muscles are also postural helpers. And those would be the lats and the ass. Lats and ass. The biggest muscle groups in the body. Funny enough, they're also the most important for performance. So let's work on them. And when we're in a turtle shape using our T-Rex arms, we can't get a lot out of the lats or the ass. The lats or the ass are meant for us to become big, to pull. Let's take up space. Let's be proud. So that's what we're gonna work on. Focus on the hips and the shoulders. Pulling, pulling. Now, even if you wanna stay down low for your sled tug in one position, that's fine, just stay proud. What is this? Your butt's gone because it's tucked underneath you. Your lats can't really fire because your shoulders are rolled in. You're pulling with your little arms. Boom! Look, I know you're crazy about your biceps. You love your bicep. Mwah. Problem is, this is still small. No matter how big you get it, it's still small compared to this or these guys. This can't do much. These can. The sled tug is about rhythm. If you don't lock yourself in place, which is fine. If you want to stay here and lock and pull from a locked position where your hips don't move, that's fine. But if you want to get it really going and you want to use your entire body, get a rhythm going. Every time you squat, you reach, and you pull. Squat, reach, pull. So you're hinging at the hips, squatting back, pull. Hinging at the hips, pull. Hinging at the hips, pull. You can actually get a rhythm that's faster than this. And you're going to build the muscle groups that are going to transfer to other skills better. Notice how Allison becomes bigger. She expands, but she doesn't twist. She keeps the posture and lets the hips and the lats do all the work, as opposed to taking up little bitty bits of space. Be proud. By the way, this is how you can move something really, really heavy. In fact, you can't really move very well from that slouched over position. So instead of always craving faster, faster, try moving more weight. This is the technique to do it.
The sled tug has little benefit when it's really light. If you're just trying to pull a lightweight fast, you're gonna lose out on the true, true beauty of it. Make it heavy in relationship to your own strength, but make it a very big challenge to tug. Keep that posture, but make it heavy. Now, even if you are using your hips better, it's still quite possible to slouch when you reach and grab for the rope. Since you're hinging and reaching at the same time, the shoulders want to round if you're not careful. So stay proud, keep those shoulders proud. Reach, grab, and keep a good posture while you're doing it.
Reach and pull, stand, extend, 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 extend. Don't forget to breathe. One of the most important parts about this is exhaling every time you come up. It's tempting to hold your breath. It feels like it's a max effort lift, like you're going all out. And you are. You still have to do quite a few pulls. So let the air come out. Breathe, breathe, breathe. Extend and pull, breathe.